Vicky's just going to say a few words for you.
Well, first of all,
I would like to say a massive thank you to all of the acts that have participated this afternoon. They've all been absolutely amazing. Charlie Botting, Rockingham Primary School, Emerald the Contenders, and Deep Roots Torturies Choir. An incredible afternoon. Thank you all so much for coming. I hope you've enjoyed it as much as I have. I would like to have the warmest thanks extended to our performers this afternoon. They've done such an incredible job of keeping us all entertained. Thank you for being such a great audience and cheering us on. I would also like to thank Paul Marlow for comparing the event and all the continued hard work that he puts into fundraising for Lakeland. Both Paul and Sophie have offered me so much support while I've been putting this event together. Once again, I would like to thank Brendan Coyle for I would like to thank him for giving up his time to be here today. It's been so amazing for the audience and for me to meet Mr. Bear. I've been completely starstruck. Thank you to everyone who's been involved in helping this event take place, especially Martin McAvoy for all his help today and Jerry Lister for my beautiful dress. Because my mum has spent so long making lovely decorations for the room, and my dad has helped with the sound today, and they've both been so amazing in supporting me with this. I'm proud to be a part of such a wonderful town and to see so many people coming together to support our local hospice. Thank you all so much for making it possible. Now over to Paul.
Just one final thank you to me. I'd just like to say thank you to Vicky and all of her family for everything they've done for Lakeland today. You truly are an inspiration to me in my job. It makes what I do all the more worthwhile. You and your whole family, and you've really made such a difference for Lakeland today. So thank you very much, guys. Thank you. I thought we'd be cheeky to ask Mr. Brendan Coyle to come to the stage and just close the event and say a few words. Mr. Brendan Coyle, everybody, Lakeland patron.
Thank you so much. Unusually for me, unless I have someone else's script and 4 weeks rehearsal, I'm not actually quite comfortable on a stage. A while back, Paul asked me to be the patron for Lakeland's Hospice in Corby, and I didn't even know what that means, a patron. I thought he said matron, I said, I come in a costume. And I thought I could just, in a token way, you know, raise funds or something. And then I got a tweet from this young lady here about 3 weeks ago, just saying, could you just retweet this fundraising that I'm doing? I thought, okay, and I had a look at that, and she's been fundraising, and putting these gigs together, and busking on the streets to create funds for this phenomenal organisation, the Lakeland's Hospice. Now, Paul came down to London. I did a voiceover documentary about the place itself. And it's amazing. And it beggars belief to me that a hospice that takes such great palliative care of people with terminal illness doesn't come under the remit of our National Health Service. I'm looking around this room now. It's our greatest institution. It was created by our grandparents' generation. A lot of people in this room after the war created this thing. Our basic philosophy of taking care of our kids, our sick people, and our elderly. It's as simple as that. And why that isn't funded by a British government, I just don't understand it. And a 13-year-old girl, friends, and everyone else here in this room has contributed more to that than any British government. I'm very, very happy to see the Mayor and Mayoress of Corby here today. I think we've got to elevate this. It's half a million a year. It takes half a million a year to provide this essential care and love. The government gives us nothing. You've given more than anyone. It's extraordinary. So I'm really proud. You know, I'm a Corby boy, born and bred. I was born in my granny's flat in Farndale Avenue. Couldn't get to hospital because it was in Kettering. That's where you had to go to be born. I was 12 pounds at birth. I don't come home very much. Because my mum still has postnatal depression, so I'm trying to give her a bit of space. But I'm very happy to come back. I just looked at Vicky's page, Charlie's here, and you know what everybody did, and I thought, well, I'm not a patron, that's a patron, you know what I mean? So I'm really proud to be here, and everybody here who's paid, you know, whatever you pay, pound in the bucket, is making people's lives better. And this place is top class facility. And we're paying for it. Us. On top of our taxes. So we have decided, Vicky and I, to make this kind of a regular thing. And I want to thank all of you for coming out today. You know, it might be a day off work, or this is Sunday lunch with your families. For me, being at Old Trafford watching Chelsea. Maybe we could agree about dates in the future. Doesn't matter, we're going to get our asses kicked in. make this a regular thing. Every single one of you has made somebody's life better today. And this is a very, very extraordinary young woman. And Des from Corby Radio said, are you surprised at the standard of talent in Corby? I said, no. You know, they sang that great song about the candle going out, the flames all your life. When I was 16, 17, I was a butcher, and I used to see the Corby candle. You know, I got to be an actor, but all my mates, writers, poets, musicians, this lot, the talent in this town, it's extraordinary, and the people I bring from all over the world into Corby Hall. Sounds incredible. I was going, yeah, it is, yeah, we're built from girders. So I'm so grateful to be here. Thanks very much for asking me. And we're going to be doing this semi-regularly. Thanks very much. Thank you so much.
What it does do for the hospice and in bringing other patients, it just helps us on a wider scale in Corby Borough. It gets us noticed. It just brings a lot of interest. So Brendan, for that, thank you very much. Much appreciated. So, ladies and gentlemen, that's all, folks. That's the end of Saturday's entertainment. A massive thank you to all of you for attending today and supporting Lakeland's. Check out our website for upcoming events. We've got Light Up a Life, we've got Christmas Bazaar, there's lots going on. We need to keep this fundraising wheel turning for the 475k a year. But honestly, thank you so much for being part of it today. Give yourself a round of applause. Thank you very much.